Holy words, long preserved for our walk in this world. They resound with God's own heart. Oh, let the ancient words impart words of life, words of hope. Give us strength, help us cope in this world.
To call on Sister Remi for her own testimony.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. Like every other person, my own testimony too is so much, but I'm just going to pick here and there. I used to be a Jehovah's Witness. Yes, and I can tell you categorically that it is not easy to be delivered. If you are familiar with them, and it all started when I was in the university, because you'll be treated like an outcast if you pull out. So. And because I knew where I was coming from was wrong. Because there are so many things that I really don't understand, I could not just cope with. At the same time, drop what I have, because I don't have substance to hold on to. So I was still there. So I think in part three, I was helped. I was just sitting down on my bed. I just decided I was not going to, because I was going to church. Sometimes I go to church, sometimes I would go to Kingdom Hall. That's what we used to call it. So I was just confused. I didn't know what to do. So on one day, on Sunday, when everybody has left, I was the only one in the room. I just sat down on the bed and I said to God, I know that you are very real, but I don't know how to serve you. Just help me. And that was all. So I was having challenge with my academics. I wasn't failing really, but I wasn't getting the kind of grade that I wanted. So I spoke with a friend, and a friend told me to speak with one of the executives in the fellowship. So when I got there, he wasn't even talking about academics. He was just talking about Jesus, talking about the message of the cross. He was saying so many things, and they were actually interesting things. Okay, so fast forward to when I graduated, I went for NYC, I came back, then marriage came to be, and when I got married, I think a year into the marriage, I wasn't just satisfied with the way things were going. And I've been going to church. I was born again. I got born again. And because my own born again was not somebody preached to me. It wasn't just, it was accumulation of so many things, reading book, listening to one thing or the other. It could be a passive comment somebody just makes somewhere, you know. And I just make up my mind, and I give my life to Christ without anybody leading me to Christ. I just decided on my own, I'm going to give my life to Christ, and that was all. So, so when I got married, and funny things were happening, I was not just ready for all of that. I was not, you know, it was just word apart. Do your own, I do my own, and it was not a funny experience. That was not my expectation actually. So. It was just what actually led me to being a witness was my quest for God. I was just looking for God. And so it was the same attitude. I know that God is somewhere. I mean, there should be more to this life than what I am experiencing. And my sister invited me to Kingdom Message, and I came. And my eyes were opening to so many things. So one day, so I was just taking what I was receiving, I was taking it home. So one day, I was just crying, and waiting on God that I had situation to continue like this. And God said, stick to your own part of the scripture. Ah, that went into the root of my being. Stick to your own part of the scripture. Stick to your own part of the scripture. I have to write it out and stick it on the wall so that anywhere I turn to, I'll be seeing it. And that's how it started. And I know I cannot say that we are perfectly okay the way it's supposed to be. But when I look back from where we are coming from, I know that we are thousands of years away from where we used to be. I also want to, you know, the word of God is transforming. The word of God is changing. The word of God is peaceful. Very, very peaceful. When I have any challenge, I just expose it to the word of grace. Any challenge, I just expose it to the word of grace. I'm going to share one experience. When my mother-in-law came, you know, she came from the village for what you used to call Omugo. And she has this vulgar word that she just used. Your head is like this, your mouth, you know, she was just using it on my child, and I wasn't comfortable with it. So what is this child picking up from this? And at the same time, I don't want to be rude. I don't know how to present the matter to her. I know this thing that you're saying is not right and all that. So I just told my husband about it, that can you address this matter? The young man is not always at home, so he was looking for opportunity that the woman would say it in his presence, and that opportunity never came. So I was just asking God, please just help me. So the day came that I have to, you know, say it to her, you know. In fact, I was almost praying in tongue when I was talking to her. But I knew that the way I presented the matter, it was Holy Ghost that took over. Because I didn't want her to go back, you know, even though she didn't change completely, you know, but she took something out of my house. She was able to pick something that, no, this world is not like that. So there are so many things. I don't want to go, you know, on and on. So I praise the Lord.
The words long preserved for our walk in this world, they resound with God's own heart. Oh, let the ancient word